Right there, guys, welcome back to the channel. So today I would say I am shocked with what's gone on at Liverpool today. I did a video yesterday about Jordan Henderson, Lavia and Colwill, and within a couple of hours I felt like deleting it because it felt a little bit redundant because things had changed. This situation with Henderson to Saudi Arabia has accelerated fast over the course of the day, as we're about to go over, right? We've had people coming out today talking about it, basically saying that it was down to Henderson if he wanted to go, blah, 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 whatever. But before we get to that, I just wanted to say something a little bit at the beginning. People have been a little bit disrespectful towards Henderson. People need to remember that this guy is factually one of the most successful captains in Liverpool's recent history, if not the, in Premier League era. He's won everything. Yep, Stevie G, better player. I will never argue that opinion, right? I will never argue against that Stevie G is a better player than Jordan Henderson. But Jordan Henderson won more valuable stuff, you know what I mean? He won the league, Champions League, League Cup, FA Cup, you know what I mean? Club World Cup. He's won it all, right? I know people are going to say, oh, well, Gerrard won multiple, this, that, and the other. But yeah, at the end of the day, Henderson got a fucking Premier League title, all right? Let's just leave that there, right? It's an opinion anyway. Like, if you don't believe me, don't believe me. It is what it is. Anyway, all I'm saying is people just need to put a little bit of respect on Henderson's name, okay? Yeah, as I said, he's not one of the most flamboyant, best midfielders out there. But people saying that his leadership meant nothing. Go back to the COVID season, when all we could hear was people on the pitch. And all I heard whenever I was watching Liverpool was Jordan Henderson barking orders about. Do you know what I mean? Now, I know, again, in the recent season, there's going to be clips going about of Henderson making a mistake with Nunes, telling him not to mark a certain player, and then that player scoring a goal. It is what it is. But was Henderson making that decision? Or was he following the orders that they'd been told to do? The plan that they'd been told to do? And obviously Nunes, new player, pretty much might not be used to the system, is going over to do what he used to do. And Henderson's like, no, you're not supposed to be there. You're supposed to be over there. Do you know what I mean? So, anyway, let's go into it all, shall we? Where should we start? So, I don't know who was the first one to mention it this morning. I don't remember. But let's start with this article from Paul Joyce, which has been updated today at 11 o'clock. So, Henderson is giving serious consideration to a move to Saudi Arabia with Steven Gerrard's team, determined to make the Liverpool captain a high-profile signing. Again, there's no formal bid that's been put in yet, and there's unlikely to be one unless the player indicates he was willing to leave Liverpool. We'll come back to that, because obviously that seems to have happened. Nevertheless, the courting of the England international is entering a decisive few days, and the midfielder is likely to hold talks with Klopp, the Liverpool manager, which will determine his future. Liverpool will seek a fee in the region of £20 million should the player look to move on. Now, Fabrizio Romano is basically saying that them talks have taken place today, guys, and we'll get to that in a minute. Another Saudi club, and I'm not pronouncing names, guys, because, you know, I'm like with pronunciation now, are set to approach Liverpool with £40 million offer for Fabinho, which would appear to indicate the Brazilian is interested in leaving. Which is true. Teams don't put bids in for players that they don't know they're going to go sign, yeah? So I would say Fabinho wants to go to Saudi Arabia. It goes on here about Henderson's financial package that he's on at the moment, and he could get more money, obviously, in Saudi, which is rumoured to be around 700 grand a week. So it goes on to here saying Liverpool's squad has 9 midfielders after the recent additions of McAllister and Szoboszlai. And the use of Trent as a midfield pivot at the end of last season means the competition for places is fierce. With Thiago, who I think as well could still leave, Fabinho, who I think will go, Jones, Bajcetic and Elliot. Klopp has been considering further midfield reinforcements with Lavia, a potential target. The Belgium international is also being monitored by Arsenal and has been valued at £50 million by Southampton. And it's just going on here. Yet the question of how Klopp is going to keep all his midfielders happy is unclear, with the future of Thiago, who has also been the subject of interest from the Saudi Pro League, and Fabinho also coming under scrutiny. Liverpool head to Germany for a training camp on Saturday, and with Klopp having stressed the importance of this pre-season as he looks to recover from the disappointment of last term, he will want clarity on the makeup of his squad. Henderson's role at club level will be key. He must also consider his England prospects, having been integral to Southgate's plans to last year's World Cup. Basically, Joyce says here that a move to Saudi may have an impact on Jordan's international chances, which, if I'm being fair, with Southgate in charge and Maguire not playing, I don't see how that would have any sort of effect. Liverpool will receive a fee for Henderson should matters progress, although it remains to be seen what that figure would be. It is likely that the $70 million that was spent on Koulibaly, who was a year younger than Henderson, could be the gauge. Saudi clubs continue to target Premier League players, da da da, it's got nothing to do with Liverpool. Right, so I agree with this, guys, in what Joyce is saying here. We leave for our pre-season tour to Germany on Saturday, so I would expect to see some progress on this. We've had confirmation today from Fabrizio Romano, I'll just get that tweet up now. So Romano basically said, 9 hours ago today, which was at 8 o'clock, so this was before the Paul Joyce article came out, the Saudi Arabian club are pushing to sign Jordan Henderson. Steven Gerrard wants Henderson and contract proposal is now huge. Still waiting for the final communication from the player's side. Deal described as in progress by sources close to the negotiation. Hendo will speak to Klopp today. Then after that, we had it 6 hours after that tweet came out. Fabrizio Romano tweeted, Henderson has accepted the proposal. There's a verbal agreement in principle. Contract agreed. Deal now depends on Liverpool and the Saudi side discussing on the fee. No chance to let him leave for a free. Hendo spoke to Klopp today and there's been a green light given. Now, to me, you can take this two ways. I think Henderson doesn't want to leave Liverpool. I think Henderson... I'll reword that. I think Henderson's first priority would be to stay at Liverpool, right? However, I also think that he would have wanted some sort of guarantee on playing time and how he's going to be used. So I reckon he's had some very adult conversations today with Klopp. And maybe Klopp's basically turned around and said, look, I can't use you as you used to be used. I've just signed all these new players. I do need to get some new players in. You know, like, you're on 200 grand a week now. Get yourself off to Saudi Arabia and earn yourself some big money. You know, set your family up forever and, you know, generations. Get yourself gone. Maybe that conversation's taken place and maybe that's why Henderson's decided, you know, I think he's loved being Liverpool captain. I think being at Liverpool is one of the proudest things of his life. And I just think him getting the confirmation from Klopp, having his friend Steven Gerrard trying to get him over there, I think that's what's convinced him and I think that's why he's going to go. I think he'll go. I think we'll get about 20 million, which ties into what Melissa Reddy said. If I just find that one. Yep, Melissa Reddy tweeted out 3 hours ago, Liverpool would expect around double the 10 million fee being reported for Jordan Henderson, given the 2 years left on his contract, his status as a club captain and England international. The 30 million valuation of Mahrez would be a reference point. So there you go, we're basically being told that 17 million for Koulibaly and 30 million for Mahrez is the go-betweens basically for Henderson. So yeah, guys, I'm shocked that he's going. I know a lot of people are going to be upset in regards to him going due to the fact he's going to that side of the world with the ambassadors of the rainbow laces and the LGBTQ. I think, but at the end of the day, take that out of the situation, guys. It's a 33-year-old midfielder that's not going to get much game time. His contract's got 2 years left on it, right? We want to reboot the midfield, and we're going to get 20 million for him. Check out the destination of where he's going. That's a good deal for Liverpool, considering we've just been losing players left, right and centre for nothing, right? So we can't turn around and say, we need a midfield reboot, and then when we do a midfield reboot, but we don't want it that much. We don't want him to go there, blah, blah, blah. We can't have it both ways, do you know what I mean? So I guess the question comes to then, who would be the new Liverpool captain? And for me, there's Trent, Alisson, Salah, Robertson. Van Dijk are the ones that potentially could become the new captain. And I don't know who I'd pick, to be fair. I wouldn't pick Salah just because I think this is his last season. And the question marks hang around Virgil van Dijk for me just due to the fact that after this season, he's got 1 year left on his contract. If he was to sign another extension, then yeah, I'd give it to Van Dijk. But other than that, I think I'm probably going to be looking at Trent or Alisson, if I'm being honest with you, because with us looking for a left-sided defender in like Levi Colwill, how long is Robertson going to be in the starting 11? Do you know what I mean? So, yeah. So I think that's the what I want to cover from the Henderson side of things. Next up, let's talk about Fabinho. So I have kind of touched on this. David Ornstein reported 7 hours ago today that another Saudi club are set to approach Liverpool with a concrete offer to buy Fabinho. The Saudi Pro League club's bid for the Brazilian international, 29, is expected to be worth £40 million. It is anticipated a decision will move quickly one way or the other. Liverpool's main opposition to any move would be letting their starting number 6 leave without a replacement. However, the club are working, if Fabinho should leave, with Romeo Lavia among a number of options under consideration. Fabinho still has 3 years left on his contract. Now, again, I think after last season, 40 million, I believe that that is the sort of player that we should be signing. We should be selling Fabinho for that price. I don't think we'd get any sort of more money for him other than that. 40 million is snap your hand off type money after last season. 29 year old as well. If you can push it to 50, 45, even better. That money would literally just cover Lavia then, wouldn't it? And then you would expect also with Henderson going, the wages being saved, we could get another midfielder in. Be that Thuram, Kone, I don't know, like people, some people are saying Casado or Tushimane, you know, as a starting number 6. Lavia is probably more of a project player. With Fabinho going, do we need to go sign someone who's more of a number one starter? Like, you're going to be the starting number 6 week in, week out. There's still question marks about Thiago as well, guys. So, we've been asking for this midfield rebuild, right, as I just said. And it seems to be we've got rid of all the old wood and we're going to bring in a young midfield. Now, that in within itself brings problems, guys, because where's the experience coming from? Do you know what I mean? They've been not hard. I mean, we'd have Szoboszlai and McAllister, who's players who've been there, seen it, done it. I kind of guess, you know, McAllister's a World Cup winning player, but I don't know, guys. It seems a little bit too quick to me to get rid of everybody of age. But then I think, in all fairness, if Fabinho goes, Henderson goes, I'd just get rid of Thiago anyway. You know, he doesn't do much for the side, does he? He's always injured. So, I don't know, guys. In sort of replacements, other players, like, who do you think could come in if we sell all three of them? Me, personally, I do see... I think if Fabinho goes, then that's Lavia through the door, 100%. Henderson, Thiago? Do we put all that money to get Thuram? Do we go for Kone? I can't see us going for Casado. Just due to the fact we want Colwell. So, do we really want to piss Chelsea off by stealing a player? Because then they won't sell us Colwell. I don't know. It's one of them, innit? A little bit of chess or something, you know what I mean? But yeah, guys. I think... yeah. It's a bit mental, innit? It's all gone a bit quick today with this. I think I'm just waffling a bit now. But I think there's one last thing I want to touch on, which was Sepp Vandenberg potentially going to... No, he's in Germany now, and he's apparently going on loan to Mainz. You know, Klopp's first team for a season on loan. So, again, that's another defender that we're down. I don't think that kid's ever played for us, like, competitively, has he? Or maybe I'm wrong there. Maybe he played in one of the cups. I think he did, actually, now thinking about it. I think he played in one of the cups. But, yeah, anyway, I guess the main talking point, guys, is Fabinho and Jordan Henderson. Like, what do you think? Are you happy? Are you not happy? Who's the new captain? Who do we get in if them two leave? Like, potentially Thiago as well. Say we sell Fabinho for 40, Henderson for, let's just cut it, 20 million, yeah? 17 to 30, say 20 million. And let's say we get 15 for Thiago, yeah? So you're getting, what, 75 million there. Who do we go by? Who are the players you're replacing them three with? Are you getting three in? Are you getting two in? Are you getting one big player in? Let me know down below in the comments, guys. And yeah, I will probably end up doing another video tomorrow because I think this could be all sorted by tomorrow, especially with the players going to Germany on Saturday. And if Henderson's not on that flight, if it's not been agreed, then I'd say the deal's on. If Henderson's on that flight to Germany, then I guess you're kind of looking towards the fact he's no longer going. So yeah, guys, I'll leave that video there and I'll catch you in the next one.